Well, good morning, guys. How are you? I want to show you something I'm doing. So, you know, cocoons, I believe, of any worm, hatch better when the environment is warm. So I put this heating mat here, which is a heating mat for plants. And these cocoons are due to hatch on December 3rd. But I also have this on a timer. Let's see, it goes off at 8 in the morning and shuts off around 7 p.m. So here they are. And right now the temperature was 70, but now it's climbing a little because of the heat mat. The ideal temperature for hatching cocoons is like 80 to 81. They say it speeds it up, so I'm here to prove it. And, you know, my temperature in the room here right now is holding steady at 70. So the bedding just felt a little colder to me. So I put one heating pad on. And I try not to touch the bottom because the heat is down there and it won't register right. So the temperature is now 75. So it's climbing. So I noticed that it doesn't go higher than like 80, 81. But this heat mat also doesn't have a timer on it. So I'm watching it really closely. But I have some new ones coming that have timers. Not timers, I'm sorry. They have thermometers so that I can set the exact temperature of what I want. But this is a good way to hatch your cocoons faster because the faster they hatch, then the faster they grow up, and then the faster they go up for sale. So, I have a few heat mats coming. And the new ones I got are not this wide because I don't want to put, you see, the entire heat mat over the entire thing. I only want like a little bit in the middle because I want to give the worms a chance to either move left or right if they don't like that heat in the middle when they hatch. So that's the goal. And I have it up there on a timer because, you know, I'm not down here the entire day and I just want to make sure that they turn off. So that's what's going on here. And usually a worm will lay an egg, and then about a worm breeds. They lay eggs about 3 weeks later, and about 3 to 4 weeks after that, the cocoons hatch. Now, the cooler your temperature, the longer it takes. I've been noticing mine are hatching within 4 weeks or maybe a little more, which is a little too slow for my taste. So we're going to put some on heat mats, and we're going to see if they actually hatch at like the 3 weeks approximately. And most commercial worm breeders that do it indoors, they do it like this. I know quite a few, and they've been successful with it because, you know, you want them to hatch so you could get them out the door. That's the goal here. So we're going to keep an eye on this, and I'll keep you updated on it. So over here, I have a tray of red wigglers. It's my 20 by, oh my gosh, I forgot the measurement. It's my 20 by 15 by 5. And I just put it here because I want to measure the moisture in this. And I want to see like the wettest maximum, like what will happen. So there are adults in here, but there's also some young ones. See, that's a really young one. He must have hatched and I didn't see the cocoon. Sometimes, guys, those cocoons are so little, and then when they start turning brown and they blend with this, forget it. You might have loads of them and not even realize it because you won't see them. So as you can see, they're over here by the chow. And I fed them this chow yesterday, and they're already digging in. Look, there's a few young ones down there. So let me wet this and let me get the measure for the moisture, and let's see what will happen. All right, here's my moisture meter. And it's moist here, but closer to the dry side. And it's moist here, closer to the dry side. What about the corners? And it's moist. I want to get it in the blue. So I'm going to wet this. Let me go get more water and see what happens. So let's wet this. I try to wet it all evenly, you know. That way, hopefully the moisture will distribute, you know, itself. And remember, if the chow sprouts, you just pick it up and throw it back down. So you guys enjoying the videos? I hope so. I'm just being myself. I love YouTube. I've been doing YouTube for many years. Even before I had a camera or anything to start filming, I learned a lot of stuff on YouTube. And you know, when I have to do a project or something and I don't know what I'm doing, YouTube is my first place to go seek help and finding. And Joe wants to do something we don't know. I'm like, YouTube it. So let's see. Oh, we're getting there. We're getting higher. There's certain spots. Now this bedding is coconut coir. And it has some cardboard shreds. You know, worms love to eat paper, cardboard. Before I leave, after I do this, I'm going to check the temperature again of that that cocoon bin so you can see if it's going up. It's going up. The moisture is going up. Now, if I want them to breed really well in the nursery tubs like here, the trick is I have to keep that moisture high, but I also have to be very careful because in something that large, if something goes bad with an extreme amount of moisture, I mean, it could be a giant disaster. It'll be a giant soup bowl and we don't need that. So I monitor moisture levels very closely. This is definitely getting higher. Because guys, without moisture and without oxygen, worms can't, they can't live. They just can't. This might do it. There, we're getting to the blue over here. We're getting close. You see, when you spray water on coconut coir, it just keep, like peat moss, it just keeps absorbing it. Except coconut coir, to me, is easier to wet than peat moss. Peat moss, you gotta, like, massage it. If you just put water and put a handful of peat moss on the surface, it floats. So that's why I tell you, when you use peat moss, work it in with warm water, because for some reason, it absorbs it faster. I don't know why, it just does. So let's see what happens with this. We're definitely on the other end of the moist now. Yeah, we're getting there. Well, we've hit the blue part. So I'm gonna stop there. I'm gonna keep letting them work in their worm chow. I'm going to cover it up, and then later tonight when I get home from work or tomorrow, I'm going to check it again, and we're going to see what the worms are doing. So let's go check the cocoon bin with the heater on it. Let's see if there's any difference in the temps, in the moisture. It's still moist. I think I'm gonna wet it down a little more. You know what I wonder, guys? I wonder with the moisture that I put in here, I know the, oh, look at that. I know the springtails are gonna love the moisture, but will they like the heat under here? That's something that I haven't really looked into. Believe it or not. Look, I'm getting on the wet side. Yeah, I wonder if it'll affect the little springtails. Because look, I have a lot of them here. Springtails come with moisture. Look at them. But I wonder what the heat's going to do. All right, so I'll check this again later and I'll bring you back. All right, guys. Let's check the temperature of the cocoon bin. There's a worm that escaped. Well, it's a cocoon bin, but there are a few in here that I didn't realize were in here. Let's check the moisture. How in the world could this say dry? It's wet. Maybe not enough to read moisture. Okay, there we go. So this moisture reader, it checks in different parts. It's more wet than others. So let's check the temperature. It feels warm. Let's see. It's climbing. So it's about 80. So I noticed that I've been keeping the heat pad on for 10 hours. And then I turn it off. Oh my gosh, that's a perfect temperature. So, yeah. All right. They're supposed to hatch on December 3rd. So let's see what's going to happen. And I didn't realize that there were some worms in here that came to live in here when I harvested everything. All right. Well, they're okay. They could stay. Oh, look. I'm starting to see a little baby there around some cocoons. See, that's a cocoon. That's a cocoon. And that's a little baby right there. So we're going to keep an eye on this and we're going to keep track. And this is the way that you hatch out those cocoons a little faster than if I were to just keep it in here at room temperature, which is usually 70 or below. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Give me the thumbs up. Check me out on my other channel, The Composting Worm Lady. Follow me on TikTok. Check out my website, thegardenandwormlady.com, and I will see you next time. Take care.